Hey, students and parents. This week for science, we're going to talk about non-renewable resources for energy. So natural resources are substances that are all around us, in the land, water, and the air. So people use these resources for energy, and all these resources come from a natural base. The thing about non-renewable resources is that once they're used, they can't be used again. They can't be remade or regrown. So some examples of non-renewable resources are fossil fuels, coal, oil, gas, and nuclear energy. Coal, petroleum, and gas are pretty common energy sources that we use on Earth. These sources are considered non-renewable because they can't be replenished in a quick time. The term often used for these three are called fossil fuels. The advantages to fossil fuels is that they can generate a lot of energy. They can be generated in one place and be done fairly cheaply. Transporting fossil fuels can be easy, and gas-fired power stations are fairly efficient. These power stations can be built pretty much anywhere, but there are also a lot of disadvantages to using fossil fuels. The main disadvantage is pollution. When you burn these fossil fuels, this creates a lot of carbon dioxide, also called greenhouse gases, that can harm the earth. Oil and petroleum spills can be particularly dangerous. Mining these resources can be difficult and often dangerous for the workers there, and can also hurt the environment in which they're being mined. Nuclear energy is created by a process called nuclear fission that uses uranium. Nuclear energy is non-renewable because once it is used, it's gone. It can't be reused. Some advantages to nuclear energy is that it costs about the same as coal, but it's not as expensive to make. It does not produce smoke or carbon dioxide, so it doesn't contribute to greenhouse gases. It also produces a lot of energy with a small amount of fuel. It produces small amounts of waste, and it can be very reliable. But there are some disadvantages. It's highly toxic, the byproduct that's produced, and it's difficult to dispose of the waste. It has to be sealed up and buried for many years, and it can cause cancer, which is very harmful to humans. Also, mining for the uranium destroys homes and habitats of animals in the environment. So let's talk about fossil fuels. This is coal, oil, and gas. The reason they're called fossil fuels is because they're made from the fossilized remains of prehistoric plants and animals, and they provide a lot for the energy needs of everybody on Earth. Here's a graphic that demonstrates how oil and gas are made. A lot of the animals and plants from many, many years ago, they are died and they're buried on the ocean floor. Their remains get buried deeper and deeper, and there's an enormous amount of heat and pressure that turns them into something that is usable for energy. That is the oil and gas. Today, we can drill down through those layers of sand and rocks. We can find the oil and gas deposits, bring them back up to the surface, process them in a form that's useful for us to use as energy. So here's a graphic about how coal is made. So again, many, many years ago, even before the dinosaurs, there were many plants and other organisms. These die, and over millions of years, they're buried under the water and the dirt. Again, the heat and pressure turn these dead plants into coal. We can dig down through the layers of dirt and rock and find the coal, bring it back to the surface, and process it into a form that's useful for energy. So now I want you to vocalize eye gaze, reach point, or have someone hand over hand assist you in looking at this graphic here. We have coal, gas, petroleum, and nuclear. So we talked about the types of non-renewable energy resources. We talked about how they're made. We talked about the advantages and disadvantages. I'll be showing you some slides and practice pages. If you want more information, I can post that as well. If you want to Zoom with me, just click on the link in Schoology.